All right. Could you state your name and rank?
Lieutenant Longnecker.
Okay. So you're basically now getting ready to attack, well, defend against the Southern Army that's approaching you. Is that about right? Or
yes, that's about right. It's the first battle, and the first battle we lose.
Altogether, how many battles does the Union Army lose at Gettysburg?
I don't have a clue. I just know that because of the, what you call a battle could be two companies facing each other or two divisions facing each other.
Okay.
They would be considered battles, but they all become one big battle.
So would you
say that? And so this is considered one big battle.
Okay. So would you say my terminology was wrong in saying it should have been a skirmish?
There would be skirmishes too. That's a smaller group.
Okay.
A smaller group would be skirmishers. They're a group of men that are sent out, and they're set out in a broad spectrum across the field. They're not shoulder to shoulder.
Okay.
They'd be 5 yards apart from each other, and the skirmishers would proceed until they find the enemy, and their job is to determine the strength of the enemy.
Okay.
And when they determine the strength of the enemy, if they hit something that's stronger than they are, they're going to withdraw.
I
see.
But
they will send information back.
One question that many people don't understand is that the Battle of Gettysburg was an important battle because it determined whether the Union would win. So do you share that sentiment that it was the most important battle of your career so far?
It became the most important battle.
Okay.
That was purely by accident the battle even occurred. Because if you take a look at General Robert E. Lee's strategy, Robert E. Lee knew he could not win. He knew that a year ago. But he was trying to force a settlement. That's why he moved into Northern Maryland. And that's why he moved into Pennsylvania. His strategy was, I'm threatening their life grain, their bread box. And that he thought, okay, the government in D.C. will settle.
Okay.
And then the Confederate would be an independent country.
That was
the strategy.
Do you see that as the battle is going to start, that maybe that Lee may have mistakenly entered this battle with his hands tied behind his back?
I would not say with his hands tied behind his back, but his communication was all fouled up. He did not have the correct information to start the battle.
Okay, so hence that's why it's a mistake?
That's why it's a mistake.
Wow.
That's why it's a mistake. He did not have communications from his cavalry, because his cavalry is over by Harrisburg.